Okay, let's try to see how we can use a presentation using the LaTeX through the Overleaf web page. The first thing is that we'll create a new project, and for this I'll just create a blank one and then insert a template. So now I have created a new project and inserted a template, and I'll just put the template with the video so you can use it if you want. So let's start by inspecting what the template looks like. So we can see we have a document class, and for this the class is a beamer. This is kind of the LaTeX name for a presentation. And then we have some theme, which gives the layout that we can see. And then we have some packages, where for example the first one allows us to include graphics in our presentation. Then we have this set for the title page. So it will be the front page of the presentation, and then afterwards we have a completely blank presentation page. To set things, we can simply just edit the text in the text file, and as we can see, if we press Ctrl S or press the compile, it will make a new PDF with the changes we have made. So everything here should be pretty much straightforward, and of course if there's stuff on the template that you don't want, then you can of course just delete it from the template. As we can see now, I have removed the need for an email. So now let's take a look at how we make the actual presentation pages. So a blank presentation page begins with a begin frame and an end frame. And of course here, I want a title for my page. So I have a / frame title, and then in some curly brackets, I just type the title I want. Now let's say that we want some equations in our presentation. So one way to do it is just like a regular LaTeX. We begin an equation by writing begin and then equation, and we can note that Overleaf helps us with an end equation, so everything in between these two will be in the equation environment. So in here we can write whatever equation we want, and if we now render it, we can see the equation is just rendered on the page as we would expect from a normal LaTeX document. Often for presentations, we might want a more fancy way to present our equations, and for doing this, we simply just need a block environment. So for this, we just write begin block, and here we need to remember to have a title for our block. Now I'll just call it block title. Now we can simply just take our equation and try to paste it inside the block, and then we can clearly see the difference on the slide. So now we can see the difference is that our equation is inside a block, and this block got a title on it. This is often very nice, because then we can name our equations in our presentation, etc. Let's try to make a new slide and then look a bit more how we can manipulate with the equations to make them look nice. So for a new slide, we needed the begin and then frame, and then we can put in a frame title also just here next to the begin frame, instead of having the / frame title. And then often I would like to have like this kind of comment and then paste it below, just to have like a visual cut between the frames in the LaTeX text. So as we can see now, we got a new frame and its title is just frame title. So now if we want some equations, again, a block is always nice. So if we begin block and then a begin equation inside the block, and we have to remember to put a block title. So this one I'll call fraction. So in LaTeX, if we want to make a fraction, we use / frac, and then we can see we got two parentheses. So we got one for the upper part of the frac and one for the lower part of the frac. So if I type x squared and maybe 1 minus x, then we can see when we press Ctrl S to render, we get a nice fraction. This is simply how we would make fractions in equations in LaTeX. In the same way, we might also want integral signs. So for this, we would simply type int, and now we can see it gives us an integral sign. Of course, int is only the first part, and often we would like it to be accompanied by a dx. So we can simply just write that afterwards. Now let's try to make another slide, and maybe take a look at how we can make listings, which is also often nice to be able to do. So if we want a list, like with dots, we can use the begin again and then write itemize. And then we can see now that we got a backslash item. And if we now try to render this, we can see we got a single item with a single dot. Of course, if we want more, then we can just in a new line type backslash item. And when we render, we can see that we now got three different items. Now let's try to take a look at how we can make a table in LaTeX. So let's start by making a new slide for this. So the tables can be a bit tedious to make sometimes, but let's start with a simple one. So again, we start with the begin command, and then we can say tabular. Now we have to decide how many columns we want. So let's say we want 6 columns. So now I'll type 6 C's. So the C just indicates that whatever is put in this column will be centered with respect to the column. Every column is then separated by an and sign. So we will also need 6 of these in every line. Then a new row is indicated by making a double backslash. So if you want 4 rows, it will be constructed like this. So let's now try to put some numbers inside the table. So as we can see, when we render it now, we kind of get a table. Of course, often we don't want the table to be in the side. And for this, we'll need some more commands to ensure we have it centered as we would often want. So to do this, we can have a begin and then say center. And if we then paste our table inside this, we'll be able to see that now our table is centered. Of course, this table doesn't look very good right now. We might want to have a horizontal line to like indicate that what's in the top are the subjects of the table. And to do this, we can have H line on either side of the first one. And now we can see we get two horizontal lines around it. Of course, we might also want to just have a singular line. And to do this, we can just move the first H line. Then we'll only have a line below it. And of course, we can use this command for any of the rows as we would like. Of course, there exist a lot of different commands you can use for tables, and Google is your friend for this. So whenever you have a need about how to do something in LaTeX, it's always a good idea to just ask Google. Now, let's take a look at the final very basic thing we might want for a presentation, and that will, of course, be figures. Because most presentations will hopefully have more figures than they will have text. So again, let's do this on a new slide. So now to do this, of course, we'll need some graphics. And for this, we can use the upload and then just find on our computer or drag the graphics into this area. So now I have uploaded a graphic, and if we want to see it, we can just click on it and it will render in the browser. Now, if I want to include it in my presentation, I'll start with a begin, and then I will write figure. And now we can see that overleaf already gives us a lot of stuff that we most often would need for figure. Do a centering, it will put the figure centered in the picture. It will tell us that we should use the include graphics command, and it will put a caption on the figure, and will also put a label. Now for presentations, we don't need labels too often, so let's not consider this one for now. We also don't want a figure caption. Of course, this is just a text that will be put below the figure. For a presentation, this is not needed. Now let's try to include the figure. So we can simply just, now that we have uploaded it, just type the name of the graphic, and then we can try to render by pressing Control S. So now we can see that the picture is way bigger than our slide, and of course we need to correct for this. To correct for this, we can use some square brackets in our include graphics. Now here, I like to use width equals 1.0 will be 100%, and then I'll do a backslash text width. So I'm telling that my figure should have the same size as 100% of how long the text is allowed to be. So now we can see that the graphics is nicely enclosed on the slide. If we just want some simple text on the slide, we can just write the text. Now we can see, if we render, that the text will be under our figure. Of course, since our figure is so big, the text is not placed in a very nice location, and maybe we want to make the figure a bit tinier, so maybe 80% of the text width. So now we can see also that the space for the text, it's simply just put by writing the text in the text file.